So, with a lot of independent inventor and entrepreneurs, why do their innovations die? Most of them die of shame. Hey, it's Don Skaggs again with Empowered Inventing, the place where we try to help you take your great idea, your great startup, your great innovation, and turn them into real things like products and businesses that make money. So I've got a question I want to pose to you today, and I want you to think about it. I want you to think about this one why question, and that is, why do some inventors' dreams die in the woods? Now, you might think that's kind of an odd question, but there's a great movie. Actually, it's one of my favorite movies, starring Anthony Hopkins, called The Edge. If you've not seen it, I'd highly suggest renting it. I'm sure it's floating around there in cyberspace somewhere. But there's a great quote from that movie, it goes like this. He says, "I once read that most people die in the woods of shame. They ask themselves, what did I do wrong? How could I have gotten myself into this? And they sit there and they die because they did not do the one thing that could have saved their lives, and that was thinking."
I once read an interesting book. It said that most people lost in the wilds, they die of shame.
What?
Yeah. See, they die of shame. What did I do wrong? How could I have gotten myself into this? And so they sit there and they die. Because they didn't do the one thing which would have saved their lives.
And what is that, Charles?
Thinking.
So, and I always thought that was a great line. And if you've not seen this movie, it involves a couple of guys that survived this plane crash in the wilderness of Alaska, and they have to fight and survive to find rescue. It's one of those genre movies, and so it's a great action adventure survival movie that uses a lot of themes of man versus nature, brains versus brawn, very well. And plus, there's a bear chasing them through most of the movie. So anyway. So what does a movie about getting lost in the woods have to do with inventing? Well, quite a bit, it turns out. Especially if you turn away from the Hollywood glitz stuff of it and look at the very real issue of survival. If you look at real world advice from experts in wilderness survival, many of them will tell you that what gets most people into trouble is when they panic or they do something just totally stupid. And the same goes with inventors. You if you panic and fear-based decisions will get you every time. So Paul Turpin, who is a former Green Beret, who teaches a wilderness survival clinic in California, he put it this way. He said, "Sit down, breathe deeply, think things over. Fear is like hot or cold. You just learn how to deal with it." So many of inventor and entrepreneur has come to me or come to me at one of the inventors council meetings or workshop, or has approached us through Empowered Inventing, and they look like they're lost in the woods. And if you think about it, if you're, you know, entering into this inventor-entrepreneur process, it's a lot like climbing a mountain or making your way through the wilderness. Even the experienced of us can run into trouble out there. So undiscovered private prior art, sudden changes to the market that you weren't expecting when you're going to sell your product or your idea. You know, there's just so many different things that can happen. That's just going to hit you from out of nowhere. So the trick is, though, is learning about what to do before disaster strikes. Now experts in the field of wilderness survival will tell you they have several rules of thumb for preventing what actually can become a hiking, camping, or for us, inventing nightmare or entrepreneurial nightmare. Now, here's just a few. Number one is always be prepared. Survival experts say that many of us get into trouble in the wilds or in the wilderness due to lack of preparedness. And many a disaster begins with words with like, I thought you brought the map. Or, but it never snows this time of year. Or what do you mean we're out of water? Now the same for surviving the entrepreneurial process. Fortune favors the prepared mind. So you have to just know what the successful steps are. And we teach those. So like the ones we teach, you have to know these successful steps in order to survive, or for your idea, your startup, your great business idea to survive the marketplace. Sometimes it's just learning the best route for your idea before you set off into the woods of product development. So another thing is have an itinerary. Successful inventors, I've heard them, a lot of them say this, is find out where you are, find out where you want to be, and then figure out how you're going to get there. So many inventors, it's like, okay, we come up with a great idea, all right, let's patent it, let's build it, let's produce a whole warehouse full of them, now let's go see if we've actually got a market. No, you don't do that. Or here's step one, here's step two, step three is a miracle will happen, and then step four is we all make money. So that's not a good plan either. So you've gotta have an itinerary of exactly how you're gonna get there. And it needs to be a very flexible. This could be a business plan, but you know, there's things about business plans. People think they're carving them in stone, and you don't need to. It is a very, very flexible. No plan ever survives. A general once said, and you've heard this before if you've watched some of these other videos, no battle plan ever survives contact with the enemy. Once you get down there, boots on the ground, things begin to change. But if you have no plan, you're going to get decimated when you hit the ground. So have a plan, have an itinerary. So don't set off into the woods without things like product development, production, marketing plan. Just you have some of these things initially figured out. And you're going to learn some as you go, and things are going to change on the ground, like I said. But you have to be prepared with a plan. So, also, let people know where you are. That's another big one with survivals. And also with inventors. Successful, independent inventors or entrepreneurs are really not independent. They're connected to other people. And as we've said in another video, people are very important for inventors and entrepreneurs, especially when it's other people within that community. Not Uncle Joe, who's never done a business, or not Aunt Sally, or your wife, or some friend of yours where they've never done anything entrepreneurial, they've never been successful. Don't listen. Hang around good people. People who can really give you good perspective of, yeah, this worked for me, no, this didn't work for me. And by their own experience is usually the best way to know that. Just like when we do here in Kentucky, we get together, we have meetings, and then we have these workshops where everybody gets together and we go around the room, introduce everyone. We work under a closed non-disclosure agreement, so it's a safe place to talk about your ideas if you've not got them totally protected yet. And so you can get input from the group of, oh, hey, you know, this really doesn't work, or this does work, or, oh, hey, I have an expertise in this type of plastic. And, you know, all types of things. But the reason why it's successful is because you're around good, like-minded people. You're around good people that have different perspectives. So the more people you're connected with, the more stories you're going to hear about what to do, what to avoid, what their experiences was, and you're going to learn from their mistakes without having to make those mistakes yourself. The more opportunities that will cross your path is directly related to the more people that you encounter. And so as you complete each step of your entrepreneurial or invention journey, you're going to the more people you get involved with, the more opportunities you will have. So when you're ready, those good connections will give you more opportunities eventually with successful buyer, with potential buyers that could, where you'd have successful sales. So with a lot of independent and veteran entrepreneurs, why do their dreams, why do their innovations die? Most of them die of shame. So don't just sit down in the middle of the woods, just all defeated. Knowing this and acting on it in the right way can potentially save your startup or your invention's life. I'm Don Skaggs. This is Empowered Inventing. If you like these, if they're helpful, please subscribe. Help us grow our tribe here on YouTube. Also, click that notification bell. Share this with someone else you think this might be able to help. And I will look to see you at the next meeting, workshop, class, or on the next video.